Hi everyone, I'm Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about our diaphragmatic absorber and how it's unique. It absorbs a lot of energy in a small amount of real estate, and people are always asking, well, how did you come up with it? How did you do that? So I broke it down into three main parts, and we're going to go over each part today. The first part is the filter. And the filter, as you can see here, is 65 pounds of activated carbon, but it's distributed with seven smaller filters inside of this thick cavity. So this is how we get the maximum amount of airflow and exposure to the activated carbon, because the activated carbon has such a high degree of porosity and such a large surface area of coverage that we want to make sure we get as much air movement as we can. So by having it exposed on both sides individually in individual filters through the whole main filter, we get that kind of impact. So the fill material of a diaphragmatic absorber gives you the rate, and the depth of the absorber gives you the level of absorption that you can have. So you need to kind of work the two together to get the performance that you want. Okay, this is part two of our diaphragmatic absorber. This is the cabinet area, and we've changed the cabinet around a little bit. I've shown a few of the layers. Each cabinet that we build has seven different layers to comprise the 2-inch overall thickness, top, sides, and bottom. So there's seven layers of material in that 2-inch cabinet wall thickness. Each layer is separated by a damping compound, and we chose the damping compounds and the densities of each layer of material, and they're all, by the way, different materials, to get the vibrational characteristics in the box. And Mike helped a lot with that design. So with all these layers and 2 inches of thickness, we get a cabinet that's very inert, very rigid, and won't really move at all, and that sets the stage for the front wall to be the most active participant in this triangle, so to speak. So we wanted a very rigid cabinet that was unaffected by low frequency energy as best we could. We didn't want the cabinet moving as much as the air in the room when you have low frequency issues. So we went with a very inert design, forcing all the vibration on the front two walls, which we'll cover next. This is part three of our cabinet discussion for our activated carbon absorbers. And this is one of the most important parts of the cabinet. Most diaphragmatic absorbers have one wall, but we have two in ours, and we worked for 2 years to figure out what density to make each wall, what material to make it out of, how much airspace to put between the two walls. Even the mounting technique is a little bit different on both walls. So one moves a little bit more than the other, and the airspace contributes to that movement, and it also assists us with slowing down that energy that enters the cabinet from the front. So our low frequency energy, which is really powerful, strikes our dual walls, it's slowed down, and then it enters into the cabinet, and based on our discussion of our activated carbon filter, it goes right through that filter. So obviously some of it goes through the cabinet, some is reflected back, and obviously some stays and is absorbed, and that's what gives you the rates and levels. Another thing that you can do with our units is you can add our foam to it, or other foams if you would like, because you have a 2-inch space here behind the fabric, and you can choose any fabric that you want to. So the dual wall aids us in slowing the low pressure energy down, so more of it can enter the inside of the cabinet, where the activated carbon can do its magic. Thank you.